In this video, we're going to be covering languages and bid strategy. If you look here, I'm in the United States targeting a city in the United States. So right here, AdWords will already recommend what languages you should target. Now, the issue comes in here is if, let's say, my Denver dental clinic happened to cater to people who speak Spanish as well. So here you could go ahead, and if you chose to, you could go ahead and say English and Spanish. However, whenever you're targeting a different language, I recommend you put it into a different campaign. So if my clinic targets individuals who speak Spanish, I would go ahead and I would create a second campaign for just Spanish. So one would be English and one would be Spanish. That makes things a lot easier to track ROI, your return on investment, especially when you're having multiple ads in there. So I'll have one ad campaign and all the ads in there will be Spanish, and then the other campaign, all the ads will be English, and then I'll have that Spanish ad going to a Spanish landing page, and I'll have my English ad going to an English landing page. It just makes the campaign management overall so much easier to manage, and you're also going to notice a good discrepancy between the cost per click. So if you're targeting Spanish-speaking individuals, chances are it's going to be a lower cost per click because there's going to be less competition in the field. So if you combine both the English and the Spanish into one campaign, your cost per clicks might actually increase. Now, AdWords representatives have told me, no, that's not really the case of how it works. But I'll tell you right now, I've targeted a lot of places internationally in Europe and all over the world. And whenever I add in English to the campaign, my cost per click rises for the native language keywords. So by just having the languages separated out, I found a lot lower cost per click overall when not including English in there. And that's just based upon my experience, which is pretty much what these videos are going off of. Next up, we're going to have the bid strategy. And here under the basic options link, you're going to have just two options. It's manually set my bids for clicks. So you'll set the maximum CPC bids in the next step. CPC is cost per click. The other option is AdWords will set my bids to help maximize clicks within my target budget. So if my target budget, let's say, was $100 a day and I selected this button, AdWords will determine what I should pay per click to be competitive in there. And the issue is especially starting off, you can have some really nasty surprises of getting charged $15, $20, $30 a click, and you're like, whoa, what's going on? Why is the click cost so high? So I really, really highly recommend that you just manually set your bids and set the bid to what you're comfortable with. So in this particular case, I'm going to set my bid to 1.51. That's what I'm going to be comfortable with. And my budget that I'm going to start off with, and I recommend everybody do this, is you start off with either a $5 a day budget or a $10 a day budget. And the reason is that way you don't accidentally spend, if your budget's $100, you don't actually spend $100 that first day without being able to see some of that first initial clicks that come in. Because those first initial clicks can tell you a lot of information, such as, whoops, I may have had a keyword in there that I really didn't want in there, and it's not necessarily relevant to what I'm trying to offer. So by keeping that budget tight, you're basically not going to spend, you're not going to lose a lot of money in one day. And you can always increase it after a few days or after the first day if you're comfortable with the keywords that you're seeing coming in. Coming over to the advanced options, the two extra options you're going to have under the advanced options link is going to be enable enhanced CPC as well as focus on conversions. Well, three options, I guess, and that's select a flexible bid strategy, which I'm not really going to cover in this video here just because it does not apply to 99.9% of all people out there. With enhanced CPC, AdWords is going to automatically optimize what you're paying per click to try to equal a conversion goal. So as conversions start coming in, it'll start optimizing your ads and tell you, okay, these keywords are converting, we're going to up these bids and get you more conversions that way. Now, in theory, you would think it would work, but in practice, I have had horrible results using this personally. It's either killed the traffic to my campaign or AdWords was paying way too much a click, and I couldn't make any money off of it. So in my personal experience, I have not had this work for me. However, it's something that I would recommend you test out. Not initially. I would initially start off with manually setting your bids, but it's something you can do is clone the campaign later once you're making money and just test it out, because as the AdWords platform matures more and more, which it's getting there, it's a very great platform right now, but it's getting better all the time. And as the enhanced CPC options increase, I think that it's going to get better and better. And same goes for focus on conversions. I've used this quite a bit before, and again, I had very, very pretty much the same results as I had with the enhanced CPC. Either it killed my traffic and I had next to nothing in traffic, or else it really didn't find those converting keywords. I was far better off manually setting my bids and manually managing my campaign. But just for the instance, we're going to go ahead and click on Focus on Conversions. Now, I just went ahead and I just pulled this up real quick for you. And you'll notice here it says your ad group might receive fewer clicks, but it's likely to receive more conversions, which can result in an improved return on investment. If there isn't enough conversion data to determine which ad is likely to provide the most conversions, ads will rotate to optimize for clicks. So at first, it'll start to optimize for clicks on you. And then is what it'll do is once it says, okay, this ad's getting more clicks, once an ad starts getting, the conversion data starts coming in, it'll start saying, okay, well, we're going to optimize this particular ad with these particular keywords because we see more conversions from it. Now, you will notice that it does say somewhere in here, if there isn't enough conversion data. So right here, and speaking with my AdWords reps over the years, that generally you're going to want at least 30 conversions on the search side. So I would wait until you have 30 conversions on the search side before you would even attempt to turn this on. However, you know, you can go ahead and try it if you want. I would recommend not doing it until you actually have a winning campaign. And I'd recommend you just manually focus on clicks. And then you manually set your bid price, your cost per click to start off. And I'm going to go ahead and do that at 1.51. And once you start manually adjusting everything, then further down the line, you can go ahead and switch it over and just see what results you get. But as of yet, I haven't had the enhanced CPC or the focus on conversions option actually work for me either on the Google search side or on the Google display side. So just to quickly summarize this whole video, languages, separate languages out into different campaigns, go ahead, focus on clicks, and set your bid manually, your cost per click, and then set your budget. Keep your budget really tight, $5 to $10 a day to start off with, just so you can engage and see the actual results that you're getting. And then from there, if you're comfortable with it, you can go ahead and increase your daily budget. In the next video, we're going to be covering a delivery method as well as the advanced settings.